Hi there, I'm David Thomson. I'm the co-founder and managing director of Annandale Distillery here in the south of Scotland. And what I'd like to tell you about today is something about our next release in our Founders Selection range. And this next release is going to be what we call an STR, and that stands for a shaved, twisted and re-charred cask. So first, a little bit about what Founders Selection is, and it's quite literally that. We go around the bonded warehouse, nosing and tasting our maturing stock, just to see how it's progressing and to see if any particular actions are necessary. Anyway, most of our spirit and our whiskey is maturing in once-used ex-Bourbon casks. But we have a fair number of other casks of different types, sherry butts, wine casks and so forth, and quite exotic casks, some of them. The very last Founders Selection that we launched was, in fact, Virgin Oak hogsheads that had been seasoned with Oloroso sherry. And after about 3.5 years, they produced the most exquisite whiskey, both the peated and the unpeated version. And these have all pretty well sold out now. So we thought it was time to launch another one. And luckily we had something waiting in the wings, and it's these STRs that I mentioned. Now, a little bit about the history about the STRs, because they were introduced to us by Jim Swan, Dr. Jim Swan, who was a consultant in Annandale Distillery and is also a friend of mine for many years. And Jim worked with a guy called Miguel Martin in Spain to develop the idea of these shaved and twisted and re-charred casks. And what they were actually were their ex-Burgundy casks, 230-litre hogsheads. And what happens is that the Burgundy's been in them for quite a long time. And so the oak staves are well impregnated with the Burgundy. And if we were to put our spirit straight into these emptied-out Burgundy casks, well, they'd draw a lot of Burgundy out from the oak, which would make the spirit quite winey in character and quite red in colour. Of course, with time, that would mature out. But also, because of the so much wine in the staves, we wouldn't get the true oak effect coming through. So what they did, and it was very clever, actually, because what they did was they developed a process where they shaved the inside of the cask just enough to take off some of the impregnated wine layer, but left enough behind. The third bit is where they actually shave the inside of the cask, and they do it to a particular depth, which is a secret, by the way, that I don't know. And they shave it to this particular depth, which is just enough to take off some of the red wine layer, leave a bit behind. It also gives access to the oak that's underneath the red wine layer as well. Now, why does that matter? Well, what they do next is that they toast the cask over a fire made with oak chips that are effectively just milled down staves from old wine casks. And they light this fire, and it heats up the inside of the cask and toasts it. And that causes the breakdown of some of the structural components of the oak, particularly lignin and hemicellulose, producing sugars amongst other things as well. And that's one of the reasons why whiskey can be quite sweet sometimes. And then when that process is done, and by the way, that also releases vanillin as well, which is terribly important in the flavour of Scotch whiskey. The final part is where they actually re-char the inside of the cask. Effectively, a big gas flame billows up inside the cask and it burns the inside of the cask. But it does it very quickly. Again, the temperature and the period of burning is kept as a secret. And you get a sort of a crocodile skin effect inside the cask. That's very common, that type of charring, and some of you may have seen it. But that's important too, because the charcoal that it produces is essentially activated charcoal. And that has phenomenal properties, particularly of absorption. So what happens is that when the spirit impregnates the charcoal, it absorbs some of the sulfur compounds that are produced during fermentation, and it binds them on and takes them out of the whiskey, thereby sort of purifying the whiskey. The other thing that the charring process does is that it effectively greatly increases the surface area. That crocodile skin that I mentioned before, it has many, many, many times the surface area of the inside of the barrel. And that allows the spirit to permeate in, right into the oak, through the wine layer and into the oak itself. And it starts to extract compounds from the oak that have been produced during the toasting process. It draws out some of the wine character, which is still left, and things like that. And it draws out tannins as well. So it's a very clever process because it's the precision in getting, taking off enough of the wine layer, but leaving enough behind for it to be to contribute to the flavor of the whiskey. So that's the STR process. I call them Swan Martin, the S1 Martin STR process, because it was those two guys who developed it. The slightly sad note I would like to add to this is that in January 2017, Jim Swan and my wife Teresa Church, who's one of the founders of the distillery, were sampling and nosing and tasting whiskies from the bonded warehouse. And Jim came up with the idea that that an STR cask would be quite appropriate for maturing our spirit. And he suggested that to us that we should order some. Now, it's worth pointing out at this stage that Jim had been previously very heavily involved with the development of Kavlan Distillery in Taiwan. And Kavlan was and still is a very successful whiskey. And in 2015, they won the accolade of the best single malt whiskey in the world. Now, bearing in mind that that whiskey was very young, it's a phenomenal thing to achieve. But crucially, from our point of view, the maturation casks were none other than the Swan Martin STRs. So they had by this time proven their worth, that they can make great whiskey. And by and large, people say it's quite fruity, the whiskey. I think it's got other characteristics in it as well, but it does add something to the whiskey that makes it a little bit different. And you know, why would you want to do that? Well, because, you know, we can use any type of cask we like as long as it's oak. And what we're looking for are casks that just make a little bit of a difference, make it a bit different from the usual bourbon casks and so forth. Just add some intrigue, add some interest. Anyway, back to the Jim Swan story. So Jim's parting words to Teresa and myself were, don't forget to order a consignment of STRs from Miguel Martin. And sadly, that was the last words Jim ever spoke to us, because about 2 weeks later, very sadly, he died at his home in Edinburgh. And Jim was a good friend and a great friend and guiding light to us here at Annandale Distillery. And to be honest, we were brokenhearted when he died, and I make no bones about that. However, you know, time moves on, and Jim wasn't a sentimentalist, really. And I think his legacy is his whiskey and the distilleries that he was very much involved with. And clearly, our STR matured spirit, peated spirit and unpeated spirit, is almost like a tribute to Jim, because it's very close to us, because his final words were, don't forget to order that consignment. So that's what we did. 3 years down the line, I think we've got some very special whiskey. And I'd like to tell you a little bit about how it tastes. If we go to the unpeated version first, so Founders Selection, Man of Words, Unpeated, and this is Cask 2017 321. Now, the appearance of the whiskey is really very golden in colour, and that's because the toasting and the re-charring process released tannins from the oak. And tannins have two effects. One, their colour, it makes your tea brown, but also it's quite astringent, so it gives that kind of mouth-puckering sensation that you get. So it plays a big role. And because of they've been regenerated, these casks, there's a lot of tannin released, so it becomes golden quite quickly. On the nose, it's got quite a lot of spice and cinnamon and nutmeg, and then the characteristic creamy vanilla butterscotch that you always get with Annandale. It seems to be kind of underpinning characteristic of Annandale, and it's quite sweet. And the palate's quite the same as well, but it brings in, when you start tasting itself, some of the fruity notes start to come in, and you get things like conference pear, summer strawberries with fresh cream, believe it or not, Braeburn apples, blackberry, prunes, and fresh honeydew melon. So the idea that these STR casks enhance the fruitiness is very clearly there. And if I then think about the peated version, well, of course, the peatiness of the whisky is such that it's going to, it's going to mask to some extent the effect of the STR. But on the other hand, it gives a beautiful balance between the two effects. And again, we've got that wonderful rich amber hue that's brought about by the release of tannins. And on the nose, and again, typically of Annandale, the peat is quite subtle. And it's quite reminiscent in this case of tobacco smoke and a little bit like smoky bacon, actually. And then behind that, there's a hint of coconut and sweet almond and cherry Bakewell. So there's something going on there that's quite nutty. And then when you drink it, when you put it in your mouth and you swallow it, as is typical with Annandale, you get this big explosion of peat. So it's quite light on the nose, but on the palate, woof, up it comes. And it brings in earthy notes with a kind of smouldering green foliage, and then creamy vanilla again, that's a characteristic of Annandale, and then fresh peach, that's the fruity note that we really see in the smoky version, and then we see a little tickle of black pepper right at the back of your throat to give it a bit of a woof. So there you are. We're launching these in the middle of July, Founders Selection. I hope you'll be interested in buying them. They're very nice whiskies, and I wish you happy drinking. Slán ti bheag.